A rare digital paint Paintball 2 Devlog. Yes, I'm still working on it. It was originally a Quake 2 mod back in 1998, and I've just put out a build in December with a large focus on bots. A lot of players weren't even aware bots were available in the game since you had to use console commands to add them, so I created a simple number of bots option to the server hosting menu, and you can also add and remove bots from the admin menu. Behind the scenes are a bunch of new settings that can be used to easily configure servers so players are never alone, even when no other humans are playing. Bot min players ensures the player count will always be populated to the specified minimum player count, and bots will disconnect when real people join. Bot min bots ensures a specified number of bots, regardless of player count. And if you just want to have fun mindlessly shooting a bunch of AI, you can set bots versus humans, which specifies how many bots to place on the server for each human. Bots and humans will be on opposing teams. All of these settings will empty the server when no human players are active, so you don't waste any resources. There have also been a number of improvements to the bot AI to better go after objectives, improved pathfinding, and a prototype setting, bot use player input, where bots will clone player input, allowing them to do all kinds of crazy jumps and movement, but due to the very precise nature of the Quake 2 movement, this only works from the exact spawn locations, and I don't currently have it saving across level changes. Though maybe that's for the best, as- what? Some people have been teaching the bots very strange behaviors.
What is going on?
There's a G-Spawn Protect server setting to give players a moment of invulnerability to reduce spawn camping a little bit, with a default value of 0.5 seconds. I've also added a new item hunt game mode to do some silly stuff for holiday events. You can specify the model, name, and number of simultaneous items in a level, as well as the pickup limit and elimination time for the mode. The new build comes with a turkey and Christmas tree model, but you can use other things as well.
Oh my god, he's a turkey butt.
You just now noticed the turkey butt?
I
gave it a big booty.
At the moment, it's a bit hacked in since it taps into the bot waypoint system to find locations to put items, so it doesn't work on maps that haven't had bots active to generate waypoints. In the future, I'll probably create specific item point entities so custom item hunt maps can be made. The client also has some bug fixes, like being DPI aware so it doesn't get scaled strangely and go off center when you have one of those big 4K monitors, and it remembers the window maximize setting. As for what's in the works now, I think you're going to be really excited about the addition of latency compensation. Yeah, I know, it's 2024, about time! The way it works is by keeping a history of the player position so a hitbox can be rewound by the ping of the shooter. The paintball projectile then travels at twice the normal speed until it catches up with the server real-time, rewinding the other players less and less with each update. This seemed like a good compromise to add latency compensation to the projectile so that the shooter can hit a target as though they are playing without latency, but after a couple server updates, the projectile behaves normally so a target trying to dodge the incoming shot won't be hit when it's a significant distance away if they're being shot at by a player with high latency. The downside is that shots can look a little weird flying out at inconsistent speeds. It's much more visible with grenades, so I'm not sure if I'll keep the latency compensation enabled on those. The first couple tests have been very promising, though.
Jesus, this fits amazing, honestly.
Fortunately, players discovered a bug on the first test where the gravity wasn't applying correctly, which meant your shots flew straighter the higher your ping was. Gravity was only being applied for the normal frame time, not the doubled speed. So I fixed that, and also broke the movement up into two steps, so it should effectively behave exactly the same as without latency compensation, just with twice as many updates until it catches up. This isn't released yet, but I test new server versions on the Social Saturday East server if you want to try it out. It'll automatically add bots when you connect. And speaking of Social Saturday, we're still doing the Social Saturday events that JMR initiated a few years ago. These are the dates for 2024. Every other Saturday, we play from 2 p.m. till around 6 p.m. Eastern Time. That means we start at 7 p.m. UTC until Daylight Savings kicks in, and then it's 6 p.m. UTC. Jump on discord.digitalpaint.org if you want to hang out on the voice chat as well. I've also been working on some maps. There's Lasagna, which is called that because it has multiple layers. And I've taken the classic Siege Castle and mirrored it into a CTF map, finally adding that village in the middle that I've always wanted to do. Some old classics that looked a bit rough have also been getting a facelift to fix things like lighting issues and misaligned textures. As always, a huge thanks to my patrons for supporting my large variety of projects and also helping me cover the server costs to keep Digital Paint Paintball 2 up and running. If you like the project and want to support it, Patreon is probably the easiest way to do that. Go to digitalpaint.org to download the latest version of Paintball 2 if you don't have it already. I almost forgot to mention that.